dan Promosi Doktor Pendidikan Pascasarjana Universitas Negeri Semarang, Selasa 9 Maret 2021, atas nama Saudari Radeni Sukma Indra Dewi SSMPD dimulai. Sekretaris Penguji melaporkan kepada Ketua Penguji bahwa ujian Promosi Doktor Pendidikan atas nama Saudari Radeni Sukma Indra Dewi SSMPD siap dimulai.
Baik. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Bapak Rektor yang amat cendekia, para penguji yang sangat terpelajar, para tamu undangan yang kami hormati, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Dengan mengucap syukur Alhamdulillah pada hari ini, Selasa 9 Maret 2021, program studi ilmu pendidikan bahasa Pascasarjana Universitas Negeri Semarang mengajukan Saudari Radeni Sukma Indra Dewi SSMPD sebagai promovenda untuk dapat diujikan disertasinya yang berjudul Formulaic Language Performance of Teachers and Students in Blended Learning Setting of Higher Education Level. Saya sampaikan kepada Bapak Rektor dan para penguji bahwa promovenda telah menyelesaikan semua perkuliahan serta telah menjalani beberapa tahapan pengujian disertasi sebelumnya di Pascasarjana UNES dan kesemuanya dinyatakan lulus serta telah memenuhi syarat untuk ujian disertasi tahap kedua ini. Oleh karena itu, saya mohon Bapak Rektor selaku Ketua Penguji untuk membuka dan sekaligus memimpin ujian disertasi secara resmi. Akhirul kalam, wabillahi taufik wal hidayah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Saudara promovenda, saat ini Pak Rektor sedang ada acara dan beliau menugasi saya untuk membuka sekaligus memimpin ujian ini dan nanti di tengah ujian kalau Pak Rektor sempat bisa masuk. Apakah Saudari bersedia?
Ya.
Baik. Apakah Saudari dalam keadaan sehat jasmani rohani?
Iya, Prof. Dalam keadaan sehat.
Apakah benar karya yang nanti Saudari pertahankan adalah karya hasil asli, hasil karya Saudari sendiri?
Betul, Prof. Ini karya hasil asli karya sendiri.
Baik, silakan Saudari baca dan tanda tangani di atas materai surat pernyataan keaslian.
Pernyataan keaslian. Dengan ini saya, nama Radeni Sukma Indra Dewi, NIM 02016160009, program studi ilmu pendidikan bahasa S3, menyatakan bahwa yang tertulis dalam disertasi yang berjudul Formulaic Language Performance of Teachers and Students in Blended Learning Setting of Higher Education Level ini benar-benar karya saya sendiri, bukan ciplaan dari karya orang lain atau pengutipan dengan cara-cara yang tidak sesuai dengan etika keilmuan yang berlaku, baik sebagian atau seluruhnya. Pendapat atau temuan orang lain yang terdapat dalam disertasi ini dikutip atau dirujuk berdasarkan kode etik ilmiah. Atas pernyataan ini, saya secara pribadi siap menanggung resiko atau sanksi hukum yang dijatuhkan apabila ditemukan adanya pelanggaran terhadap etika keilmuan dalam karya ini. Semarang, 9 Maret 2021, yang membuat pernyataan Radeni Sukma Indra Dewi SSMPD.
Baik, ya, cukup. Siap ya?
Siap.
Okay. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Ujian promosi doktor pendidikan Saudari Radeni Sukma Indra Dewi SSMPD secara resmi saya nyatakan dibuka. Selanjutnya saya perkenalkan tim penguji Saudari Ketua Profesor Dr. Faturrahman Embum, Sekretaris Profesor Dr. Agus Nuradin Embum, anggota 1 Profesor Dr. Suwandi MPD sebagai penguji 1, 2 Profesor Dr. Rudi Hartono MPD sebagai penguji 2, 3 Dr. Eko Handoyo MSI sebagai penguji 3.
Ya, Pak Direktur.
4 Profesor Mursyid Saleh MA PhD sebagai penguji 4. 5 Profesor Dr. Dwi Rukmini MPD sebagai penguji 5. 6 Profesor Dr. Januarius Mujianto MHum sebagai penguji 6.
Siap, Prof.
Terima kasih. Selanjutnya dipersilakan saudari Promo Penda untuk berdoa terlebih dahulu.
Sudah, Prof.
Baik, silakan saudari paparkan karya saudari, maksimal waktu 15 menit.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Yang Bapak Rektor Universitas Negeri Semarang, yang terhormat Bapak Direktur Pascasarjana Universitas Negeri Semarang, and all of the honorable examiners and audience. Good afternoon, my name is Radini Sukma Indradewi. Please allow me to present my dissertation entitled Formulaic Language Performance of Teachers and Students in Blended Learning Setting of Higher Education Level. Let me start first from the background of the study. In this Industry 4.0 era, the workforce, especially the student, is expected to be fluent in using technology and fluent in English, because English is currently used by 1.75 billion people worldwide, and the English native speakers tend to use lexical bundles, collocation, idioms, and so forth, which the researcher here refers as formulaic language. On the contrary, the first semester students are still using the word-for-word style to communicate. They face a problem in producing natural and inappropriate expression. So together here, the teacher and the first semester students have to master the formulaic competence. In accommodate this problem, the blended learning can accommodate a broad range of technologies without having to live face-to-face learning in the classroom. The research question here consists of 4 research questions, the main problem. Into 1, how is the formulaic language performed in teacher-student blended mode of classroom interaction? How is the formulaic language performed in teacher-student online mode of classroom interaction? And how is the formulaic language performed in teacher-student offline mode of classroom interaction? And the last is, how is the relationship between the modes of interaction? And the research objectives trying to answer the research question, which is to explore the teacher and student performance of using formal language in blended mode of classroom interaction and in the online mode of classroom interaction, in the offline mode of classroom interaction, and to explain the relationship between the blended online and offline mode. To find the strength of the studies, The review of previous studies conducted consists of some theoretical. They are competence and performance of communicative competence. The basis of the theory actually regarding into Celso Murcia 2007 and the functional formulaic competence and the formulaic language theory from Ray, Burdelsky, Cook, and Weber, and the formulaic sequences from Dickinson, formulaic expression and lexical bundles from Fitriati, idioms, collocation, phrasal from Mohammed and Mujianto, and also the classroom interaction pattern. From the review of previous studies of the present research investigated of formulaic language, but with a different focus. However, This study is different from all of the previous type of research in terms of classroom interaction happen at blended learning setting. The theoretical framework underlying this study consists of three main modes. To reveal the blended mode of classroom interaction, the online mode of classroom interaction, and in the offline mode of classroom interaction, which the main mode has their own characteristic. And the research methodology used to investigate this present study, first, the design is the qualitative approach. Technique used is a content analysis with the approach of discourse analysis. The research setting and participant used to analyze the formulaic language performed among teachers and the first semester students of English Department of UNIMUS in 2018, 2019, and 2020 academic year. Three English teachers and 77 students were chosen as the participants. And the data used the classroom observation, documentation, audio recording, video recording, and the interview. Method of analyzing the data starting from the transcribing, identifying, categorizing from the based on the Bibert's framework, interpreting the finding and drawing conclusion. The instrument used in this research was a framework categorization of formulaic expression proposed by Bibert, and the second instrument was an observation sheet and observation checklist. The unit of analysis of the present study were major and minor clause. And the triangulation, the researcher here applied the method triangulation. This section presents the findings for the first finding in terms of formulaic language performed by teachers and students in blended mode classroom interaction revealed that there are 7 types of formulaic language performed. They are routines to express greeting and leave-taking, agreement and disagreement, and express certainty. The other insert lexical bundles divided into structural and functional types, collocation, multi-word units, idioms, and binomial expression. The table and the pie chart below describe the frequency of the formulaic language types performed in blended mode of classroom interaction. In terms of formulaic language performed by teachers and students in online mode of classroom interaction, it revealed that the teachers and students perform 4 types only of formulaic language. They are routines, insert, collocation, and lexical bundles. The following table and pie chart describe the frequency of formulaic language types performed in online mode of classroom interaction. In terms of formulaic language performed by teachers and students in offline mode of classroom interaction, it reveals that the finding, based on the finding, teachers and students perform 7 types, routines, insert, lexical bundles, collocation, multi-word units, idioms, and binomial expression. The following table and the pie chart describe the frequency of formulaic language types performed in offline mode of classroom interaction. In terms of the formulaic language relationship between the modes of interaction, the relationship here exists, which is the similarity relationship between the offline modes and the blended mode. Whether the online mode has only 4 types of formulaic language performed by teachers and students. The findings of how the relationship between the modes of interaction reveal that 7 types of formulaic language performed in the blended mode, 4 types of formulaic language performed in the online mode, and 7 types of formulaic language performed in the offline mode. The similarity relationship exists between the blended and offline mode. We can conclude that the same characteristic of formulaic language performed by teachers and students in the blended and offline mode. The blended learning, which identified by Sharp and Allen, showed that blended learning actually can refer to the combination of the online and offline. However, based on the findings, the relationship between formulaic language performed by teachers and students in blended mode can substitute the online mode, especially the vocabulary learning of formulaic language with some special requirements. Those are of technology, include the internet and learning management system, supporting management system, synchronization of teachers and students, and interactive materials. The conclusion reveal that the findings of how teacher students perform the formulaic language in a blended mode related to 7 crucial issues. They are routines, insert, lexical bundles, collocation, multi-word units, idiom, and binomial expression. But in the finding of the formulaic language performed in teacher-student online mode of classroom interaction, only reveal that there are 4 types in the conversation. The characteristic of formulaic language performed in the offline mode mostly has the same characteristic with the formulaic language performed in the blended mode. This phenomenon happened because of the blended learning model is a combination between the online and offline. The similarity relationship exists between the blended and the offline. So the results reveal that teachers and students already perform formulaic language, but with a different characteristic. The teacher has no difficulty in producing formulaic language and sounds like a native speaker. On the contrary, students have to struggle hard to speak fluently, even some of them even produce the inappropriate formulaic language. The suggestion were addressed to the students, teachers, for the researchers, and the institution. The students should give more attention to formulaic language to help them speak naturally and fluently. And also they have to change their communication goals. And teachers should be considered the sociocultural and linguistic aspect when teaching English to students. Second, the teacher also has to facilitate the teaching and learning process for the digital natives. The further researchers might work with a more significant number of participants to reach more generalizable conclusion. And the institution should facilitate comprehensive technology system, including the internet, learning management system, synchronization of teachers and students, and the interactive material. The pedagogical implication regarding to the study. First, the second learners should be made aware of the importance in performing formal language through innovative learning management system. Second, the teacher should explain and plan well to introduce the first semester students to perform formulaic language through various technology. And teachers should also determine which types of formulaic language, how they want to introduce them in the real conversation, and how they are acquired for second language learners, and when the target of formulaic language acquisition has to be accomplished. This is my publication and presenter certificate based on the research findings. The article title of the proceeding in ICASI Banda Aceh, proceeding of ICET in from UNES Semarang, and the journal from International Journal of Psychosocial Rehabilitation. And this is the certificate of the presenter. This is the end of my presentation. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Terima kasih, Pak.
Selanjutnya akan ada tanya jawab. Penguji pertama Profesor Dr. Suwandi MPD. Dipersilakan, Prof, waktu maksimal 10 menit. Arahnya Prof Andi belum.
Oke, terima kasih. Yang saya hormati Bapak Rektor, Profesor Dr. Fakhrul Rahman yang sangat cendekia, Bapak Direktur Pasca, Bapak Profesor Dr. Agus Nuryatin yang sangat terpelajar. Terima kasih atas kesempatan yang diberikan kepada saya. Selamat Ibu Radeni Sukma Idradewi yang sudah menyelesaikan disertasinya dan saatnya sekarang Ibu Radeni untuk mempromosikan temuannya yang spektakuler dalam penelitian. Once again, congratulations, Buradeni, for completing your dissertation. Stay calm, but Buradeni, my questions won't be hard. Yeah. First, let me start from your motto. Is it a personal motto or an educational motto? Life is a process. Competence and performance is two different things. Is two different things, so are two different things. A motto stated in the scientific paper dissertation should be related to the research finding. In this case, motto of educational, not personal motto. Just keep, let me give you an example of educational motto. A better learning future starts here. Let's say like this, yeah? So what do you think?
Very, yeah. Thank you, Prof, for the question. Actually, the motto here, reveal the first motto, it's not an educational motto. Yes, that's right. The life is a process is not an educational motto, but the competence and performance is two different things actually related to the findings of my research. Based on my findings, some students actually already have the competence in formulaic language to saying English sentence appropriate, but some of them maybe have some anxiety or a shy to express it in front of the classroom. So I make it on my motto, competence and performance is two different things.
Okay, now my questions related to your dissertation. Why do you take formulaic language performance of the teachers and students in blended learning setting of higher education level as the title of your dissertation? To what extent is the role of formulaic language or expressions for the teaching of English in Indonesia?
Thank you, Prof, for the question. Formulaic language play essential role in oral language development. If the students learning formulaic language, they have memorized the chunks already. So when they want to speak, they don't have to translate it from the Indonesian language. They still use the word per word style, and sometimes they still produce inappropriate expression. So the formulaic language plays an important role in the oral language development, especially in enhancing the student's fluency in speaking English.
But as far as I know, teachers or lecturers never focus on teaching formulaic language or expressions. Anyhow, students are still able to speak English well. What do you think?
Yes. That's right, Prof. Even though the teachers never focus or plan well the formulaic language in the speaking material, actually the students still can understand and interact with the others. But in order to achieve the fluency like a native speaker and to facilitate the students in speaking, actually the formulaic language was needed in order to maintain the communication flow.
Okay, good. My next question is concerning your abstract. Abstract is an important part of your dissertation. It is the case containing the important points of your paper. The readers will continue reading your full paper if it is considered to be crucial. The typical kinds of information included in the abstracts are background information of your research, central questions or statement of the problems your research addresses, why is that topic worth examining, research method, main finding, significance or implication of your finding. And I think this is the general order of the informations covered in the abstract. Does your abstract contain these points?
Actually, some of the part of the abstract already specified those main parts, and maybe in the last paragraph, there are some addition need to be revised again in order to get the perfect dissertation.
Let's say the last paragraph of your abstract should be put at the beginning of the abstract, yeah, because this is kind of the background of the study. Yes. Okay. Oh, yeah. Okay. Next, on page 159 and 211, you mentioned the frequency of formulaic expression used by the lecturers and students in online and offline settings, and they are different. For example, in online, insert 146, lexical bundles 147, and collocation 159. In offline, insert 131, lexical bundles 116, collocation 68. The question is, why it is different? What makes them different?
Yes, thank you, Prof, for the question. Based on the research findings in terms of research question one, the formulaic language performed in the blended mode of classroom interaction actually is the combination between the online and the offline mode. And the frequency revealed from the type of formulaic language performed the different numbers of types of formulaic language. So actually in the offline, the teachers and students produce more formulaic language just like in a blended mode. But in the online mode, the teachers and students have a limited times to interaction because the meeting in the online mode only six times in a semester. So the frequency is fewer than in the offline mode.
But they use more insert in online rather than in offline, or lexical bundles also in the collocation. So they use more formulaic expressions in online, not in offline.
Yes, I'm sorry, Prof, in the page of 169.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Can you take a look at page 100? 11 and 211 and 159.
There are table 4.143 in overgeneralization and using preposition. Is that right, Prof?
That's the frequency of the formulaic expression used by the teachers and students, right? In offline.
In offline, great. In the offline mode, the teachers and students produce six types of formulaic language, same like in a blended mode. So in the offline, the teachers and students produce more formulaic language better than in the online.
Yeah. Offline is better than in online.
In the offline, yes, more.
Yeah.
More formulaic language produced than in the online mode.
Yeah, why? Why they are different?
Oh, yes, thank you, Prof. The meeting conducted in the offline mode is about 8 meetings in a semester. So the interaction between the teachers and students are more maximum in the classroom, but the meeting in the online mode only 6 meeting, and the online mode used to transfer the material which has not been teached in the classroom. So the meeting in the online mode has a limited time than the offline.
So it is because of the time of the number of meeting, yeah.
Yeah.
In online, students and teachers have limited time, while in offline, they have more time to meet.
More time, same in the classroom.
If they have the same quantity of time, do you think that they will be different?
If they have a same quality of time, I don't think so that it will be different, because there are some of the difficulties also show up in the blended learning.
Okay. Now my next question is dealing with the pedagogical implication. What is meant by implications?
Implication is something deal with the action regarding pedagogical in teaching and learning process.
Mm-hmm. This is the effect or consequences that may happen in the future. Yeah.
Yes.
In this case, the future of the teaching and learning of it. Oh, time is over. Unluckily, time is over. So Thank you so much for your answer. Dan terima kasih Bapak Direktur atas waktunya, dan saya kembalikan kepada Bapak. Terima kasih.
Terima kasih Prof. Wandi. Penguji kedua, Profesor Dr. Rudi Hartono MPD, silakan waktu maksimal 10 menit.
Baik, terima kasih. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Yang saya hormati Bapak Rektor, Profesor Dr. Fathur Rahman M. Hum, dan Bapak Direktur yang sangat cendekia, juga Bapak Ibu para penguji, dan ada Bapak Rektor Universitas Veteran, ya, selamat datang Prof. Dr. Rustono. And congratulations Mbak Sukma, ya, for your work. So today, yeah, it is your second term, yeah, to defend your work. Yeah, I hope that you can answer all questions well. Okay. You did your research, yeah, in the topic of formulaic language performance done by students and also the teachers, yeah. And then maybe you have many previous studies, yeah. And then you see also some gaps of the research, or research gaps. I want to know what is your main research gap, so it encourages you to do your research.
Thank you for the question, Prof. The main research gaps encourage me to do this research. Actually, the formulaic language performed between the real setting in the classroom rather than happen in the blended learning setting. The blended learning setting now is very trend to use in the teaching and the learning process due to the pandemic era. So I think there will be a research gaps in if there are some research conducted in this study, because the formulaic language plays a essential role in the oral language development.
Okay, and then the second one, yeah, maybe it is also the problem, yeah. You did your research, yeah, in investigating the formulaic language performance in the classroom done by the teachers and student. Using a blended learning approach, yeah, and then you use Edmodo and Joom. You know that Edmodo and Joom are both different, yeah, different internet portals. You know, yeah, Edmodo is what they call that learning management system, yeah, while Joom is the platform, yeah. Why didn't you use the same, yeah, the same platform or the same what they call that learning management system, yeah, while both are different, yeah, how come you manage the different devices or internet portal for your research, yeah?
Oh yes, thank you, Prof. Why I didn't manage the same portal for my research, actually it based on the condition itself. At the 2018 and 2019, this research conducted using Edmodo, and it still used at the 2020, but at the pandemic era, the teaching and learning process also using Zoom as an additional platform to use in the speaking class, because in the Edmodo, sometimes the student still have some difficulties to speak with other friends, because we have to record our audio first and then we have to upload it first. But in the Zoom platform, we can talk and interaction in the real time by face-to-face interaction.
Yeah, but I think, for example, Google Classroom, yeah, Google Classroom is what they call that learning management system is as the same as Edmodo, yeah, because nowadays Google Classroom also has what you call that video conference facility, yeah. But it's okay. That's your choice to use Joom, yeah, instead of other platform. Okay. When I check chapter 3 in relation to research methodology, I don't know whether you are consistent or not in using the term. Yeah, you said that in your abstract you use content analysis, yeah, content analysis, while in your chapter 3, yeah, you said you use discourse analysis, yeah, which one, because you should be consistent. In my mind, it's better for you to be consistent in using content analysis, yeah, not discourse analysis, yeah. Maybe it's different view between discourse analysis and content analysis. Although in the qualitative research there is name, there is design names, discourse analysis case study, yeah. But you have more than one research question, yeah. How come you only did your research or analyzing the data using content analysis while you see or observe, yeah, you saw or, and observe the interaction in the classroom, yeah. Didn't you use other research design like classroom observation, yeah?
Yes. My apologies, Prof. The research design is qualitative and it uses a content analysis, but in approach of discourse analysis. And in my research, also instruments an observation sheet and observation checklist. So I think and the findings when the table and the pie chart describe the frequency, it only to present the description, not only as a mean to recount the data.
Yeah, you mean that you use qualitative research as the as approach, and then content analysis as your design, yeah. But you stated in chapter 3, yeah, it is what discourse analysis, not content analysis, yeah. In my mind, it is content analysis, not discourse analysis. Or yeah, you will use, or you said that it is a discourse analysis case study because it is the special name for one of the qualitative research design, yeah. Okay, maybe you can check it again, yeah, in order to make it consistent, yeah. You are consistent in using the terminology of research design. Okay. In what formulaic expression, yeah? In what formulaic expression did the student dominantly or mostly have problems?
In some type of formulaic language performed by students, there are some types performed that are insert routines.
Yeah, which one? Which one is the dominant one or mostly done? Yeah, as a the student problem.
There are the most commonly problem actually, and it's not the main purposes to find, but the
yeah.
Sometimes the student produce some produce the inappropriate expression, like when they're saying he is there, or they should say take a look at this, but they say let's see. So sometimes they also have some inappropriate expression when saying idioms like a thick wallet. So actually it in all of the formulaic language performed, they have some inappropriate expression, but they have a different expression.
Yeah, I mean that it is also the interesting one if you also focus on what we call the dominance problem, yeah, for students or teachers in expressing the formulaic expression in their oral interaction, oral activities, yeah. Okay, the last one, yeah. What model or concept as the research novelty, yeah, do you create, yeah, based on your research?
Yes, thank you, Prof. The model of the research novelty based on my research findings, actually based on the findings of research question one, I could propose that there are 7 types performed in the blended and 4 types performed in the online mode and 7 types performed in the offline. So actually we can conclude that there are the same characteristic of formulaic language performed by teachers and students between the blended and the offline mode. So actually the blended learning mode here can substitute the offline mode. So especially in the vocabulary learning of formulaic language.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, thank you so much. It is, the time will be up. Yeah, thank you so much for your answer. Terima kasih Pak Direktur, cukup.
Terima kasih Prof. Budi. Penguji ketiga, Dr. Eko Handoyo, M.Si, dipersilakan Eko waktu maksimal 10 menit.
Terima kasih Pak Direktur, Bapak Rektor yang saya hormati, Bapak Direktur, Sekretaris Penguji yang saya hormati, Bapak Ibu para penguji, Bu Rara, Bu Radeni ya, banyak Bu Rara ya. Bu Rara ya. Selamat sudah masuk pada tahap akhir ya.
Terima kasih.
Oke, okay, Bu Rara, I have some question for you ya. Why did you choose the theme? What problem and what are interesting to?
Okay, thank you, Prof. I choose the problem regarding this research about formulaic language because formulaic language play an essential role in the oral language development. With mastering the formulaic language, the students don't have to memorize a long expression. They can use the formulaic language to interact with another just like a native speaker. So I think the problem of the research is really important and essential in the English foreign language.
Okay. Maybe you can show the problem face in the object of your research.
Oh, yes. Bro.
Yeah.
The problem based on the object of my research is sometimes the students still produce the inappropriate expression regarding to what they produce in the classroom. Sometimes for the routines, they should produce take a look at this, but they some of them still saying, let's see. So for the collocation, they still produce the beautiful of. Actually, they should saying the say the beauty of Bali instead of the beautiful of some place.
Okay. Next, ya.
Yes, bro.
Okay. Why did you choose the English department student from Unimus, yeah?
Yes.
Not others.
Yes. Thank you, Prof. I choose the English department of Unimus because the accreditation of English department of Unimus already a B score and the university B.
Yeah.
B, Prof.
B, yeah. Okay. Yes.
The accreditation is B and the university already have the good infrastructure of technology. So the teaching learning process can be conducted using the learning management system. And the teachers there already have a professional knowledge as an English lecturer, but some of the students still produce an inappropriate expression.
There are Unimus have problem, serious problem, because Unimus have B score.
Yes. Yeah. The
maybe Unimus, you found problem okay. In interaction student and teachers or lecturer.
Yes, the problem refer from the interaction between the students, the first semester students. Especially between the teachers and the students and the students and the students when they interact the other in the classroom or outside in the classroom.
Maybe influence of pandemic COVID-19?
There is no influence of pandemic COVID-19 because my research conducted from 2018 before the pandemic started.
Oh. Okay. Next, yeah. As an observer and analyze during your data collection activities, do you have no difficulty in retrieving data?
Yes, actually, I have some difficulties in collecting the data. The difficulties are in terms of recording the data at the classroom. Using the audio recording and the problem related to recording to use video recording. Mm-hmm. But actually those problem already get the solution when the pandemic started. There are so many application used to record some video in the learning management system. So start from the last year, we can use some application to record video, but
before video, that, yeah.
Yes, we okay. Can.
Okay. The result of your decision revealed that both the teachers and students already use various types of formulaic expression with different characteristics. Please try to show the difference in the test characteristic.
Oh, yes. Thank you, Prof. The teachers and students perform the formulaic language, but with a different characteristic. This also revealed from my findings when the formulaic language types of lexical bundles, the teachers already fluent in using the lexical bundles, especially in the structural types and the functional types, especially in stance bundle ability, but the students still struggle or hard to produce those lexical bundles.
Okay, enough, yeah. Okay, next, Bu Rara. Based on your research, are there any difference in formulaic language types performance in online mode classroom interaction? Please explain to me, Bu.
Oh, yes. Thank you. There are some differences for the formulaic language performed in the online and the offline mode. Because of the limited time, the teachers and students also have some limitation in producing formulaic language in the online mode, because the online mode just conducted in 6 meetings. And in the offline mode, the teachers and students has no limitation because they already familiar to meet and interaction in the classroom. So in the online mode, there has more limitation.
Okay, enough. Okay, next, Bu. Yeah. Based on the result of your research, what are your suggestions for improving student formulaic expression so that class interaction become more lively?
Oh, yes. Thank you, Prof. My suggestion regarding to the students should be aware of the formulaic expression they performed. This could be happen if the teachers also facilitate them to teach in the to perform formulaic language and how the second language acquisition and the time of the target when the formulaic language have to be accomplished.
Okay. Next, Ebu. Okay. Can the result of your research be generalized to other English department students?
Yes. Thank you, Prof. Based on this qualitative study, and the study is a case study, the result of the research cannot be generalizable to another researcher. So I have some suggestion to another researcher to conduct another research, maybe on the experimental or quantitative, to see the impact of formulaic language, how they affect the fluency or the competency.
Okay, last question, yeah. From the various research findings of your dissertation, what theory do you produce and will offer to the English language teacher and teacher community? As you know, a doctor is like a philosopher, so having to theorize, it is not enough to produce practical findings for language learning. Please.
Yes. Thank you, Prof, for the question. Based on the research finding, I propose a novelty regarding into some theory. The theory based on the blended learning mode, which can substitute the online mode. So based on the experience, some online mode has more applicative way in the teaching and learning process, but actually the blended learning process can substitute the online mode, especially in the vocabulary learning and of formulaic language or the English era.
Okay, after you achieve doctor degree, what do you do?
I will contribute to my university and
in effect, yeah?
Yes, bro.
Okay.
Try to do my best.
Okay. Oke, okay. Congratulations, Bu. Selamat. Masih Prof. Agus, saya kembalikan kepada Prof. Agus.
Terima kasih, Pak Eko. Penguji keempat, Profesor Dr. Mursyid Saleh, MA PhD. Dipersilakan, Prof, waktu maksimal 10 menit.
Terima kasih, Bapak Direktur. Mbak Aradeni.
Oke, Prof.
Okay, let me first join the other examiners in congratulating you on your having completed your dissertation. Now that you are sitting there for your open examination, let me wish you a great success.
Thank you, Prof.
Well, actually, I would just like to gladly say that I don't have any particular objection to your research. There may be just two or three points for you to clarify anyway. The first one is about the term relationship. The term relationship that you use in your last research question. You haven't been explicit there what kind of relationship it is that you want to know about. Yes. Your last research question.
Oh, yes, the research question number 4, how is the relationship between the modes of interaction? Actually here, regarding to the relationship, how of the formulaic language perform between the modes of blended online and offline.
What kind of relationship? What kind of cause and effect relationship or comparative relationship?
Based on the research findings, it revealed that there are similarity relationship between.
Okay. Similarities or differences?
Similarity, Prof.
Okay. Yeah. I just want you to be explicit there. Be explicit. So don't just how is the relationship, but what differences and what similarities are there? So use the term differences and similarities rather than
relationship.
You have to be explicit, you have to be specific in formulating your research questions.
Yes, Bro.
Okay, that is first. Or are there any other type of relationship, like lexical relationship or semantic relationship?
And there is another addition of relationship between of the, based on the findings from the types of lexical bundles, show the relationship between the structure and the functional relationship.
Okay. So just be explicit. Okay. Yes. Now the second, you mentioned in your literature review about Edmodo and Zoom.
Yes.
Two types of platforms, of online platforms.
Yes.
And I think, who was that? Prof. Wandi or Prof. Rudy, who had asked the same question about Edmodo and Zoom. I didn't find any further explanation or discussion in your research, not even in the collection of your data and also in the research methodology about the two different types of modes. How about that?
Oh, yes. My apologies, Prof. Actually, I have mentioned the blended learning modes consists of two platforms, the Edmodo, at the 2018 and 19, and Edmodo and Zoom used at the 2020 in conducting the research. So actually, those two learning different platform used, but in the different year.
Okay, of course, you have mentioned it to Prof. Rudy, I think. But have you discussed it in your dissertation about the differences of the two platforms?
Oh, my apologies, Prof. I will discuss it later on the
theoretical. Yeah. I know you have explained it to Prof. Rudy very clearly, but I couldn't find it in your dissertation. And also whether there are differences or similarities of the formulaic expression used by the students or teachers in either one or both of the two platforms. Okay, yes. So please consider having this further discussion on those two types of modes.
Yes.
Okay. Ma'am. And also, I think with regard to the teacher and students, you haven't made any comparison between students and teachers in the use of formulaic expression. Have you?
The comparison between the formulaic language performance by teachers and students actually consists of the same data that are the teachers and students interaction. So I'm not trying to compare, but the conclusion revealed that the teachers already fluent in producing formulaic language.
In the conclusion.
Yeah.
Well, why didn't you try to separate the students and the teachers' performance separately and then compare them?
Oh, yes. Yes. Actually, the separation between the teachers and students and students' interaction already mentioned before, but on this blended mode, divided into three modes, blended, online, and offline. So it makes in one systems together.
Okay. Right, just make sure that everything is there. Okay, and then the third point, the same question as Prof. Wandi's question with regard to your motto or mottos. Okay, my question is whether you have two mottos there. Two motto, yeah?
Yes,
my question is whether your mottos there belong to any type of the formulaic language, and if they do, what type of formulaic language do they belong to?
Yes. Thank you, Prof, for the question. Actually, the motto here, I mentioned two mottos there. The life is a process. Competence and performance is two different things. Actually, the competence and performance belong to the collocation, consists of noun and nouns.
Collocation.
Yes, Prof.
Okay. Competence and?
Performance.
Competence and performance.
Yes,
collocation or by binomial?
Sorry, Prof. The collocation
or? Collocation, is it?
Activity, in stating the activity.
This one is like father and mother, isn't it?
Oh yes, so it can be categorized into binomial expression. Binomial.
Yeah, okay, yeah. Competence and?
Performance.
Yes.
S or R.
Yes.
Is.
Oh, shame.
Down to one.
Competence and performance is gitu.
Competence and performance, I'm sorry, Prof, are two different things.
Yeah, ini calon dokter kok kayak gitu ya. Okay, performance and competence two different things. Okay. Well, about triangulation. What did you do for triangulation, actually?
The triangulation conducted in this study actually used the methods triangulation to check the consistency of the findings, but also there are some validators beside the method of triangulation.
Validators? Who are they? Who were they?
The validator is the English lectures in order to check the consistency of the findings.
Mm-hmm. And what did they say?
Based on the findings and the observations and checklist, it could reveal that the formulaic language performed by the teachers and students have the same consideration with the result of the study, that the teachers already produced the formulaic language in fluently, but the students still produce some inappropriate expression.
Okay, And you are sure you have included in your discussion?
In the end of the discussion, actually I have included some of this statement.
Okay, that's fine. Thank you very much. Once again, congratulations, Radhini.
Oh yes, thank you, Prof.
Terima kasih, Bapak Direktur. Cukup dari saya.
Terima kasih, Prof. Murid. Penguji kelima, Profesor Dr. Dwi Rukmini, M.Pd. Dipersilakan, Prof. Dwi, waktu maksimal 10 menit. Suaranya, Prof, belum keluar.
Suaranya, Prof.
Oke. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Thank you very much, Bapak Rektor and Bapak Direktur Pasca Sarjana for the chance given to me. And Mbak Radhini, congratulations.
Yes,
you have successfully over there for defending your dissertation.
Yes.
Yeah. Wish you good luck.
Thank you.
Okay. My first question is related to the topic of your study, that is formulaic performance of teachers and students in their interaction, right? Yeah.
Yes.
Your suggestion is, okay, you raise, yeah, when answering the questions of the examiners, you seem one the students of English department of the university you did your study,
yes,
a high target, that is mastering the use of formulaic expression. Why so? Because we know that English is our foreign language, but your hope seems too high.
Yes. Thank you, Prof, for the questions. The university accreditation is B score, and also the English language department has its own UPT Bahasa, means regarding into testing the students into TOEFL test. So the English language department has a high target, not only have a high target, but they want to acquire the English as a second language acquisition in a fluent and to speak naturally like native speaker.
Thank you. But why don't you say that later on the graduate will be an English teacher? So
they have to master the formulaic competence.
Including that,
yes.
Yes. Okay, add that please, that later on they will be a teacher of English, so they have to master also the use of formulaic expression in order to have a native-like competence in speaking. Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Next, this is also the same questions like what Prof. Mursid asked you related to question of problem number 4. Here you ask about the relationship between the 3 different modes of interaction. Yes, I don't think that this is a relationship. Even when you give the answer at the end of your explanation, those are not relationship, but differences and similarities. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. You said that you have analyzed and found the inappropriateness of the student using formulaic expression. Can you give just 2 examples or 1?
Yes.
appropriateness of the student's formulaic expression.
Oh, yes. Thank you, Prof, for the questions. Some of the inappropriate expression of routines reveal when the students say, let's see, but they should say, take a look at this from the routines. And for the collocation, when they discuss the beautiful of some place, they say the beautiful of instead of saying the beauty of. So the students trying to translate from the Indonesian language into the English language.
So have you explained this in the discussion, that this can be the influence of Indonesian language? Blah, blah, blah.
Yes, actually I have mentioned it into some table of inappropriate expression of insert collocation and those who have the inappropriate expression.
What I mean is that the reason why, okay, they say it inappropriately.
Okay. Later.
Okay. Yeah. Somewhere on page 98, you write that the instruments for obtaining data is also, okay, by means of document. But I don't think that you use documents for obtaining data.
Oh, yes. My apologies, Prof. The document itself means of the documentation of teaching and learning process, but I don't analyze the formulaic language performed in the document used to teach. So this used only as a complement data to get the meaningful data of the classroom interaction.
Oh, I see. If, okay, you didn't really take the data from document, don't write that.
Oh, yes.
Yes, okay. And then this is also related to the setting when you give the explanations of terms, yeah, definition of term. You explain a lot here about blended learning setting. Yeah, you explain a lot, but you didn't wrote here which, okay, blended learning setting is yours.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. So add that, please. Yes?
Yes,
Bro. Tambahin ya.
Yes. Yeah, Bro.
Dan teorinya ditempel semua. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. You use three modes. Blended. And then offline and online learning.
Yes,
yeah, Bro. Of those mode that teachers and students performance the best.
Okay, the best. Thank you, Prof. The mode which the teachers and students perform the best actually when they perform in the offline modes, because they can meet each other, they can interact each other like in the real classroom, in the face-to-face learning, in the offline mode. So actually in the online mode, they have some limitation because the teachers don't have to take a look at the online mode all of the time.
Oh, I see. Have you written that in the discussion of finding?
Actually, I have written that, but in the different ways of relationship, similarity, and I will add
similarity and differences. Yes, okay. And then these are only suggestions when discussing about your finding. You give the code, yes, something like datum 5 and then diagonal line 9, but you didn't explain in the methodology what kind of code it is. Yeah, some people will think that that is extraordinary number or figure. Would you explain, please, in your methodology?
Yes,
please. Yeah. Another suggestion is about the conclusion. Yeah, you still have, okay, you still, okay, wrote the finding over there. Yes?
Yes.
Why so? Yeah, those conclusion, I think, are conclusion in every paragraph, yeah, are too long. Can you shorten, please?
Yes.
Just to give the answer of the question of problem.
Yes, ma'am.
Not too long. And put all things in the discussion and findings.
And findings.
Yeah. Or yes. Maybe you write twice.
Yes.
So give only the answer of the question of problem. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you very much. These are all for me. Prof. Agus.
Thank you, Prof.
Thank you very much.
Terima kasih, Prof. Rukmini. Penguji keenam, Profesor Dr. Januarius Mujianto, M.Hum, dipersilakan.
Ya, terima kasih, Prof. Terima kasih, Prof. Agus Nuryatin yang sangat cendekia. Thank you. Radeni Sukma, first of all, I would like to congratulate you on completing your draft, and you are allowed to sit here for your promotion. First thing that I'd like some clarification from you is about the word formulaic. Yeah, formulaic. Yeah. Here in the dictionary, yeah, formulaic refers to containing or consisting of fixed and repeated groups of words or ideas, right? And then in your title, you have higher education. Yeah, is this expression formulaic or not? Yeah, higher education. Yeah, is it formulaic or not?
I think yes, Prof. It is formulaic.
It is formulaic, right? Now, what about higher pedagogy? Is it formulaic or not? Higher pedagogy.
I don't think so.
Okay, yeah, I agree with you. Okay. And then next point that I'd like to ask you is about table, yeah, table, the word table, yeah. You have a lot of tables, so many tables, yeah. Okay, so many tables. Are they really tables or not?
Pardon me, Prof. Are they?
Okay, are they really tables or not? Yeah, okay. Here we have table 4.1 up to table 4.100 something, right? Yeah, 148 tables. Now, my question is, are they really tables or not?
Based on my understanding, the table show the interaction between.
Okay. Yeah. Have you checked the meaning of table in the dictionary or not? Okay. Yeah. So you feel that you see the meaning of table, but then in the dictionary, it is said that a table is an arrangement of facts and numbers, yeah, arrangements of facts and numbers in rows, right, or block, specifically in printed form. Okay, yeah, and then you've got to check it again. Is it an arrangement? Is your table an arrangement of facts and numbers in rows or blocks or not? If they are not, facts, arrangement of facts and numbers in rows or blocks, then they are not considered to be tables, right? Yeah, so there are some, of course, on page 112, for example, yeah, page 112, for example, it is really a table just because it contains, facts and numbers, yeah, facts and numbers in rows. But yang lain, yang kebanyakan yang lain, they are not tables, but they are just samples. Okay. They are just samples. Yeah. So instead of using the word table, then I think it's better for you to use the word sample. Yeah. Sample one, sample two, sample three, yeah, sample four, and so on. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Right. And then next point is about the differences or the difference between figure, chart, and diagram. Yeah. Yeah. You check the meanings of those terms in your dictionary?
Yes, actually, I have checked it, Prof. Figure, chart, and diagrams, it's difference.
Okay, is there any difference or not?
Yes, they have some.
Yes. Difference. Okay, yeah. If they are different, then you have to categorize them in accordance with the definition. If it is a figure, then the figure is there, right? If it is a chart, then the chart is there, and so on, right? And then they belong to different categories, okay? They are not the same categories, okay? And then next point is for you to clarify what is meant by first semester students. What is meant by first semester students? Your thesis, of course.
What do I mean by the first semester students? Regarding into the first the students who have just entered the university in the time of they just entering the university as an English language teacher. So I refer here as a first semester students.
Okay, yeah, because in your definition of key terms, you said that first semester students is pre-service blah, 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 right? Yeah, pre-service blah, blah, blah. Okay, so which is a bit different, of course, yeah. Okay, so try to see again the clarity of your definitions, okay? To make sure that they are really operational definitions in your dissertation, yeah. Okay, and then next point is for you to check again, the use of APA 7 edition guides. Of course, you have already applied the ideas in the APA 7 edition, but the problem is that you are not accurate enough. Kenapa tidak accurate? Karena kurang teliti. Anda kurang teliti. Some pages which I highlighted at the time, then you make corrections, but yang tidak saya highlight itu beberapa bagian itu lepas, lepas dari koreksi begitu. So that's why that I ask you again to be more careful and revising your draft. Okay. And then the next point is for you to again write references and also the way you cite expressions or any ideas from the sources. Now the question is, have you checked your dissertation using Turnitin or not? Yes or not?
Yes, I already checked it, Prof, using Turnitin.
Okay.
Yes.
And how many percent did you find the similarity index?
About 20%.
20%, yeah. Okay, so that's another PR for you, right? Yeah. Okay, you've got to narrow it down into maximum 15%, right? How can you narrow it down to 15%? That's by rephrasing, sentences, which you quoted from the sources. Okay.
Yes.
First is Turnitin, yeah, 15%. And then, did you check your paragraphs in APA 7 edition? In Grammarly.com, application.grammarly.com or not?
Yeah. Yes, I already
checked. Yes, you have. But again, you are not teliti enough, right? Yeah, Anda tidak teliti. Sebab I still found out that there are still a number of ungrammatical expressions, yeah, okay, according to application.grammarly.com, yeah, okay, check it again, yeah, okay, and then also check it in APA 7 edition, okay, yeah, right, and then last, oh, almost, yeah, ketelitian, that's all, and I think that's all. Yeah, thank you very much for your attention. Terima kasih, Prof. Agus Nuryatin.
Baik, terima kasih, Prof. N. Dengan demikian, maka pertanyaan dan sanggahan penguji ujian promosi doktor selesai.
Ketua penguji menunda ujian untuk memberikan waktu kepada para penguji melaksanakan rapat yudisium.
Untuk memberikan waktu kepada tim penguji dalam menentukan hasil ujian, dengan ini ujian promosi doktor atas nama Saudari Raduni Sukma Indradewi SSMPD dinyatakan ditunda.
Rapat yudisium dipimpin oleh ketua penguji. Ujian promosi doktor pendidikan dilanjutkan kembali. Ketua penguji membuka kembali ujian promosi doktor pendidikan.
Ujian promosi doktor pendidikan atas nama Saudari Radeni Sukma Indra Dewi SSMPD dinyatakan dibuka kembali. Selanjutnya saya bacakan berita acara ujian disertasi tahap 2. Pada hari ini, Selasa tanggal 9 bulan Maret tahun 2021, di Pasca Sarjana Universitas Negeri Semarang, UNES, telah diselenggarakan ujian disertasi tahap 2 atas nama Radeni Sukma Indra Dewi SSMPD pada program studi ilmu pendidikan bahasa Pasca Sarjana UNES dengan disertasi yang berjudul Formulaic Language Performance of Teachers and Students in Blended Learning Setting of Higher Education Level. Setelah dilaksanakan ujian dan dilaksanakan rapat penguji, keputusan tim penguji menyatakan bahwa Radeni Sukma Indra Dewi SSMPD dinyatakan lulus sebagai doktor pendidikan. Dr. Radeni Sukma Indra Dewi MPD adalah doktor ke-590 lulusan UNES atau doktor ke-123 lulusan Prodi Ilmu Pendidikan Bahasa Pasca Sarjana UNES dengan masa studi 4 tahun 6 bulan. Karya ilmiah disertasi diberi penghargaan dengan nilai A, sehingga IPK menjadi 3,75. Hasil akhir ujian promosi doktor pendidikan dengan predikat kelulusan sangat memuaskan. Atas nama Ketua Penguji Sekretaris, Profesor Dr. Agus Muryadi Nembung. Pembacaan selesai.
Ketua penguji mempersilakan promotor untuk menyampaikan pesan dan kesan.
Promotor dipersilakan menyampaikan kesan dan kesan.
Oke, terima kasih Bapak Direktur yang sangat cendekia, para penguji yang sangat terpelajar, para hadirin yang kebetulan mengikuti acara ini, dan Dr. Radeni Sukma yang nantinya akan menjadi sangat cendekia. Itu, first of all, I should like to congratulate you on the completing your draft. Selamat ya, Anda bisa menyelesaikan studi Anda itu 9 semester ya, 9 semester dengan IPK tadi sudah disebutkan 3,75. Anda adalah salah satu dari 13 ya, mahasiswa angkatan 2013 dan dari angkatan 2016 ya, oke. Okay. Dan dari 13 mahasiswa itu Anda adalah mahasiswa ke-8 yang sudah lulus ya. Lebih dari separuh ya, 8 yang sudah lulus. Masih ada 5 yang satu menghilang, dan masih 4 yang belum lulus, mungkin segera akan lulus. Di antaranya ada yang hadir di promosi ini, begitu ya. Ini sekaligus mendorong mereka supaya lebih cepat lulus, gitu ya. Ini jadi congratulations lagi untuk Anda dan congratulations untuk keluarga ya. Ya, dan juga segenap pejabat di tempat Anda bekerja, gitu ya. Saya sampaikan selamat untuk mereka. Lalu kesan atau pesan yang hendak saya sampaikan kepada Anda ialah bahwa dengan lulusan dengan kelulusan ini, Anda itu bisa diibaratkan memanjat tebing, ya, olahraga panjat tebing, ya, panjat tebing amat susah itu, ya, dari bawah 50 meter ke atas Anda panjat dengan menggunakan berbagai alat gitu. Kemudian itu Anda memerlukan perjuangan yang sangat keras gitu. Terus panjat, panjat, panjat sampai di puncak, ya, tebing itu, lalu Anda mau apa gitu loh, ya. Anda sekarang ada di puncak tebing itu. Anda mau apa? Apakah mau terus-menerus di puncak tebing itu? Enggak kan? Tidak, ya. Anda akan turun lagi, ya. Turun dengan mudahnya, ya. Kalau mau cepat turunnya, ya jatuhkan diri aja, terbuk, ya, sampai, ya. Tapi mungkin Anda turun dengan pelan-pelan juga sambil menikmati keindahan mendapatkan gelar doktor begitu, ya. Tetapi setelah itu, ya, setelah puncak tadi, Anda harus turun. Anda harus share, harus membagikan pengetahuan Anda, pengalaman Anda, seluk-beluk yang berkaitan dengan perjuangan Anda memperoleh gelar doktor ini, sehingga teman-temanmu, terutama yang empat tadi, ya, ketularan itu, ya, tertular oleh prestasi Anda, dan adik-adik kelas juga, tidak hanya adik kelas, juga kakak kelas, ya, kakak kelas masih ada beberapa yang belum lulus juga akan ikut ketularan untuk panjat tebing seperti yang Anda lakukan itu. Walaupun setelah sampai di puncak tebing harus turun lagi, tapi dengan turun dari ketinggian tebing Anda dihadang, dihadang oleh manajemen, dihadang oleh para mahasiswa, dihadang oleh para juniors, diadang juga oleh kalayak akademik perguruan tinggi untuk memperlihatkan kualitas Anda sebagai seorang doktor. Kalau menulis, mesti tulisan doktor yang bagus. Kalau mengajar, mesti mengajar yang bagus. Kalau mendidik, mesti mendidik dengan benar, dan seterusnya, dan sebagainya. Sehingga kedoktoran Anda itu menjadi lambang, ya, merepresentasikan keberadaan Anda sebagai lulusan doktor, dan itu doktor lulusan dari Universitas Negeri Semarang, begitu, ya, English Department lagi, begitu, ya. Oke, okay. Nah, sedangkan untuk teman-teman yang mengikuti promosi ini, saya pesankan, ya, tirulah apa yang sudah diperbuat oleh Dr. Ratini Sukma, yang baik-baik ditiru. 5 semester itu, oh, berapa? 9 semester itu termasuk lumayan, ya, termasuk lumayan, walaupun belum lumayan sekali, ya, ada beberapa yang hanya 8 semester begitu, tapi lumayan daripada harus dipolkan sampai 12 semester atau bahkan 14 semester begitu, ya. Jadi selamat untuk itu, congratulations, ya. Oke, setelah ini kerja Anda, ya, pengabdian Anda akan menjadi lebih mantap, dan jangan tunggu lama-lama, Anda susul prestasi Prof. Wandi, Prof. Agus Nuryatin, dan sebagainya. Anda juga nanti tempelkan gelar di depan nama Anda menjadi Profesor Dr. Ratini Sukma. Ya, ya. Begitu pesan-pesan saya. Terima kasih. Terima kasih, Prof. Agus Nuryatin. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Ujian promosi doktor pendidikan atas nama Dr. Radeni Sukma Indra Dewi MPD ditutup oleh Ketua Penguji.
Baik, sebelum ditutup, atas nama Ketua Penguji, saya mengucapkan selamat kepada Dr. Radeni Sukma Indra Dewi MPD. Selamat sudah meraih gelar tertinggi akademik. Kalau dalam bahasa saya, saudara sudah mencapai puncak gelar tertinggi. Diberikan oleh Prof. Yan tadi sudah ada di puncak, mau apa? Kalau dalam bahasa saya, puncak itu diratakan kembali. Jadikan landasan dasar untuk menuju puncak yang lain.
Amin, amin.
Puncak yang lain apa sebagai akademisi? Satu, tentu targetnya menjadi profesor karena sudah lebih. Artinya seseorang dalam menapaki kehidupan itu meraih sampai ke puncak tertentu, puncak itu diratakan untuk menjadi dasar untuk mencapai puncak berikutnya. Itu akan penuh dengan tantangan. Selamat juga pada suami, ibu, dan mungkin anak-anak. Ya. Juga selamat dan terima kasih kepada keluarga besar IFET, Universitas IFET Semarang. Ini yang tercatat Profesor Dr. Rustono M. Hum. Kalau ini menghadiri, kelihatannya ada kamu dari Belmawa yang sedang menekan kontrak itu. Selamat. Kemudian ada Dr. Lulu Eliana MSI, Wakil Rektor 1 Universitas IFET Semarang. Selamat juga kepada Bapak Suyanto STMPD, Wakil Rektor 2 Universitas IFET Semarang. Kemudian selamat pada Dr. Andes Tri Laksono MPD Kons, Wakil Rektor 3 Universitas IFET Semarang. Bu Lulu, selamat ya Bu Lulu. Nah, sukses di tambah doktor ini.
Terima kasih, Prof. Terima kasih banyak,
Prof. Agus Nuryatin. Terus Pak Tri Laksono, selamat. Dan besok Pak Tri Laksono akan ujian terbuka. Jadi besok tambah doktor lagi Universitas IPET.
Alhamdulillah.
Kemudian Dr. Fifty Isti Kaili Enkes, Dekan FKIP Universitas IPET Semarang, selamat juga. Terima kasih. Lalu Dr. Maria Geno, BA, MPD, Ketua Prodi Pendidikan PG PAUD Universitas IPET Semarang. Selamat sekali lagi. Bu Lulu itu yang masih belum dokter, segera saja dimasukkan ke UNES ya.
Siap, Prof. Beres.
Tambah dokter. Baik, dengan mengucap syukur Alhamdulillah dan dengan seizin Bapak-Ibu serta hadirin sekalian, ujian promosi doktor pendidikan atas nama Dr. Radeni Sukma Indra Dewi MPD secara resmi saya nyatakan ditutup. Terima kasih. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Acara selesai dilanjutkan dengan pemberian ucapan selamat. Ucapan selamat diawali dari ketua penguji yang pada kesempatan kali ini diwakilkan oleh sekretaris penguji. Kepada yang terhormat Profesor Dr. Agus Nuryatin M.Hum dipersilahkan.
Baik. Sekali lagi atas nama Ketua Penguji dan saya sendiri sebagai sekretaris mengucapkan selamat kepada Dr. Radeni Sukma Indra Dewi. Mudah-mudahan makin amanah.
Amin.
Dan tambah berkah.
Amin.
Terima kasih.
Dilanjutkan oleh anggota tim penguji diawali dari Profesor Dr. Suwandi MPD. Kepada beliau dipersilakan.
Baik, terima kasih. Bisa didengar suara saya?
Ya.
Oh, bisa ya, oke, terima kasih. Selamat kepada Ibu Dr. Radeni Sukma Indra Dewi. Semoga kesuksesan Anda akan bisa menjadi berkat bagi orang lain.
Amin.
Bagi keluarga dan lembaga. Demikian, terima kasih.
Terima kasih, Prof. Suwandi.
Dilanjutkan oleh Profesor Dr. Rudi Hartono MPD, kepada beliau dipersilakan.
Ya, baik, terima kasih. Selamat dan sukses, Mbak Sukma. Ya. Ya, semoga ilmunya bermanfaat dan berkah untuk orang banyak. Dan terus lakukan penelitian, tidak boleh berhenti walaupun Anda sudah melakukan penelitian besar harus dilanjutkan dengan penelitian-penelitian yang
lebih besar.
Ya, terima kasih.
Terima kasih Prof. Rudi, terima kasih.
Dilanjutkan oleh Dr. Eko Handoyo, MSc, kepada beliau dipersilakan.
Terima kasih Mbak Ermin. Selamat Bu Dr. Rara Sukma. Semoga ini menjadi langkah awal untuk menuju sukses yang lebih gemilang. Terima kasih.
Terima kasih Pak Eko, terima kasih.
Dilanjutkan oleh Profesor Mursyid Saleh, MA, PhD, kepada beliau dipersilakan.
S7 ya Mbak. S7. Syukur. Selamat. Sukses selalu. Sehat.
Amin.
Sejahtera.
Amin.
Solihah. Solihah. Oke. Okay. Assalamualaikum yang ke-8.
Terima kasih Pak, semoga sehat selalu.
Amin.
Dilanjutkan oleh Profesor Dr. Dwi Rukmini, MPD, kepada beliau dipersilakan.
Halo Mbak Sukma. Congratulations.
Thank you.
I wish you all the best. Semoga barokah, barokah Allah.
Thank you. Yeah.
Dan cepat jadi profesor.
Amin. Mengikuti juga Ibu, Men. Terima kasih, Men.
Dilanjutkan oleh Profesor Dr. Januarius Mujianto, M.Pum. Kepada beliau.
Ya, terima kasih. Saya sampaikan 5K. 5K. Tadi promosi 58S. Ini 5K. Congratulations, 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 congratulations. Ya, ya sukses selalu. Ya, terima kasih. Ya,
terima kasih. Dilanjutkan oleh undangan diperkenankan untuk memberikan ucapan selamat. Terima kasih.
Selamat Mbak Sukma, Mbak Rara.
Mbak Rara, selamat Mbak Rara.
Mbak Rara.
Happy for you Mbak Rara.
Yang Sukma di sini.
Oh iya Mbak Sukma. Mbak Rara, terima kasih.
Sukma kembar.
Selamat terus ini jadi dokter ini. Dua Sukma ada jadi dokter.
Bu Sukma sudah lulus.
Wah, congratulations. Iya. Selamat untuk memperkuat LPP English Camp-nya Go Internasional deh. Ini dokter bahasa pertama di Unisvet.
Wow,
pertama kali.
Amin.
Kebetulan sudah ada beberapa
selamat
dokter.
Selamat Unisvet, selamat Ibu WR1 iya. Dengan
terima kasih. Silakan mampir ke Unisvet. Monggo.